And at Landmark, you know, we've worked with over 2 million people around the world, mm-hmm. and what we've found is that upsets are basically boiled down to one of three reasons. The first one is an undelivered communication. So something you haven't said to somebody or they haven't said to you. Mm-hmm. So it's just been there under the surface, right?
Right.
The second one would be a thwarted intention. So something that you wanted to go a certain way, but then it went askew. And then the third one, which is a very popular one, is an unfulfilled expectation. Mm. You know, something that you hoped would happen or that they'd say or do and they didn't. Even though most of the time we don't even tell people what we expect, mm-hmm. we just expect it and they should know if they love us to do those things, you know, and then we get upset when they don't. It's crazy.
Why are you not reading my mind?
That happens a lot, actually. And I know I find in my own family that sometimes you think maybe you have communicated something because you've thought about it so much that you really haven't. Mm-hmm. So how do you draw that out? How do you begin that open book communication with someone that you know you've already at odds with?
Well, I think once there's an upset happening, once there's an argument happening, let's say, you know, like for instance, I had somebody I was coaching who went home to her mother-in-law's house for a brunch with her husband, and her mother-in-law told her, come at noonish. Mm. What is noonish,
yeah.
right?
Mm-hmm.
It's left up to interpretation. So
at 12:15 she was late.
Exactly. Exactly.
You know, at 12:01 she was late.
12:05 was noonish for her mother-in-law, but for her 12:25 was noonish. So she showed up, you know, and it was like nothing was wrong, but her mother-in-law opened the door and was upset already. Oh. The vegetables were overcooked, you know, mm-hmm. she started banging pots. I mean, this is a moment where you can either get caught up in the upset or you can diffuse it. So mm-hmm. one of the things you could do is you could actually take your mother-in-law aside or take your 9-year-old aside or whoever it is and say, what's happening?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, talk to me, tell me what's happening.
Yeah.
And it's good to take them aside so they're not on the spot in front of everyone in the family mm-hmm. and just don't react, just listen to what's mm-hmm. actually happening. And if you're the one who's getting upset, then find somebody who's a good listener and talk to them and say, listen, I just have to say this, and this is what's happening right now. And, you know, again, somebody who won't react.
Right.
Well, you always say act versus react. So how can we put those building blocks in place before an event to make sure that we're not reacting?
Exactly, because if you can be proactive and take action, then you don't have to get stuck in a heated situation adding fuel to the fire, right? So one of the ways you can do that is turn your expectations into requests. Which we're not great at making requests, you know, this is not a
give
big...
Give me an example of how you would do that.
I'm going to give you an example from my real life, okay?
Okay.
So, I know, my real actual life. My parents just celebrated their 50th anniversary.
Oh,
so,
wonderful.
So great.
Congratulations.
Yeah. It's so amazing, right? So we had this party and I was going to remarry them. They were going to renew their vows. So a few days before the wedding, my father called and made a request. He said, I request that the boys, my 8 and 11-year-old, don't bring their electronics to the wedding.
Mm.
And I was like, great, thank you so much for making that request, because now we can avoid that whole upset.
Yeah.
Because that upsets him, it triggers emotions in him.
They're playing, you know, video games. It's not that they're just playing video games, it's that they're not being with him.
Right. Mm.
So for him, he interprets that as, you know, they don't spend time with me, they're not interested mm-hmm. in all that. So that request averted a whole upset that could have happened.
I love requests, but, and we only have just a minute or so left, because here's the big one. You know, we all go with so much baggage. You know, there's, especially with family, things that have happened years ago
right.
that you have buried and you're not going to forget it. And you see that person, maybe you haven't seen him in a long time, and it triggers all of those emotions again.
It does.
How do you just get over that?
Well, the first thing is knowing that it's your past experience that's coloring your experience right now. So it isn't what's happening right now that's upsetting you, ever, by the way. It's always the interpretation you're adding to what's happening, and usually those interpretations are based on the past.
Mm-hmm.
So if you can catch, the moment you start getting upset, if you can catch it and go, okay, what is this right now? What is this from the past that is unresolved? Or what is it that is my intention that's getting thwarted? Or what is it that I haven't said to this person mm-hmm. since 1975?
You know? That's usually the case, right?
Exactly.
I don't even, some people say, I don't even remember
yeah.
that, right?
And half the times they don't, they just know that that person triggers something in them that doesn't feel comfortable. And is there any simple tool, one solution, like you said, if we are finding ourselves unraveling, should we step outside?
I would literally just take a moment and say,
pour a glass of wine.
Yeah, that helps too. Depending, whatever works for you. But ask yourself what's behind the upset. And again, it'll boil down to one of those three things. Mm-hmm. And if you can actually get to the source of what's upsetting you, you can begin to diffuse diffuse it and address the real issue rather than the kind of fireworks that happen that you'd like to have happen on 4th of July, but you don't want to have happen with your mother-in-law, right?
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. I just want to put you in my purse and take you home right now. That's what I want to do. Well, we put all these tips and more, how to avoid family fights, on our website, SonoranLiving.com. Jocelyn, thank you so much. Always good to see you.
Oh, so good to see you guys.